welcome, my friends, foes, subbies. Tonight I am here to discuss a topic that is hot in the streets right now. Somebody that I dedicate this song to.
What they do, they smile in your face. All the time they wanna take your place. The backstabbers, backstabbers, they smile in your face. All the time they wanna take your place. The backstabbers, backstabbers, all your fellas.
This is dedicated to Tasha K. Unwind with Tasha K. Now, Tasha, you say that you're a journalist. I don't know if you went to school for it, but there are a lot of mistakes that you made, and I wanted to make this video to call them out. There's going to have to be another video after this because your second part to this terrible interview that you recently did, that was very biased, there were no receipts. So I guess you were reading comments and seeing that people felt some type of way. Now all of a sudden you have receipts and screenshots and all that, which I could have sworn you said screenshots and stuff like that were not real receipts. So please don't come with any screenshots. Please don't do that. And to be honest with you, I already know what you're going to use as your evidence. And I'm hoping that I'm right, because let's just say I already know what's going to be, what the tea is going to be beforehand. I wish there was a way for me to record it. And you know what? I might save it so that I could reveal to you exactly what I know that Tasha is going to give you as a receipt, which is invalid. Okay. I made a comment on your video interview with Star, and I'm going to read that to you. But before I do that, I would like to say that what you're doing is very dirty. You know that Miss Mona Simone had that interview scheduled with Star, okay? Star even promoted that on her page. And what did you do? You kept writing Star under her comments and asking her to check her DMs. So basically, next minute I look, Star no longer has that promotion of her interview with Miss Mona Simone. Tasha, you're dirty as they come, aren't you? This is real fucked up, because Miss Mona was trying to get back into this YouTube game. She was one of the originators that was here from before people were getting paid, and this would have been like her breakout. Like, she would have probably, you know, got way more followers off of this interview, but you ruined it. But I will tell you this, you ruined it for Mona, but at the same time, I think it was a blessing for her, because this woman that you interviewed, Star, is a complete fraud. And I don't understand why you would just believe her off of her verbalizing shit without receipts. I don't get that. That's not what journalists do. And I would love to say other people that made videos names, but I'm not going to do that in this video. I'm not going to. Well, one thing I will say, I'm going to make a video expressing how I feel about you as a person, because I believe that you indeed are a narcissist. I talk about narcissism on my channel all the time. It took me a while to realize that's what you were, but I have all the proof. And I'm going to put it together so that other people could understand exactly what I mean when I express that. You are a narcissist. Whew. Girl. Now let me read this to you before I go ahead and talk about key points to this interview that just... my blood was boiling. All right. Here goes my comment that I believe that you muted so nobody else could see it or whatever. Maybe it offended you. Who knows? Doesn't matter. I'm just being real. And I don't care if anybody comes and attacks me and puts all them damn wine emojis everywhere. I love wine. I drink it every day anyway. So go ahead. Go ahead. Tasha, Tasha, Tasha. So because this girl didn't stutter and sounds articulate, she's telling the truth. So many things I want to call out from watching this fuckery. This by far was one of the absolute worst interviews ever. Number one, she mentioned being in trouble with the law several times, yet you never asked her For what, right? You never did. Number two, you said Cardi admitted to living in the same building when in fact Cardi said she worked in the same building. Yeah, and that's documented on Facebook and on Instagram. Anywhere, even if you Google it, you will see Cardi said they worked in the same building. Bad journalism on your part. Number three, you finished this girl's sentences for her on several occasions. Why not let her finish? Number four, you kept throwing shade at Cardi low-key every chance that you got, and that shows your real agenda. Number five, you tried to make a cold sore out to be like an STD and asked Star if Cardi infected Offset as if she would fucking know. That was really awkward. Really, I'm just disturbed. Number six, you ain't shit. And you will truly get your karma after this, because what you're doing trying to ruin someone else to elevate you is not gonna last long. Yes, I noticed that your numbers are going up. There are a few people that unsubscribe, but that doesn't matter to you. I noticed that you kind of do love the drama. I'm looking at your responses to people, and it just brings you so much joy to see the pain that you're causing others. But then when someone else calls you out, I notice that you go crazy. I wish I screenshot this, but this is going to be my read to you to show you that you're a narcissist, because you've been diagnosed, okay? Not by just me. I noticed a couple of comments under your videos saying that you are a narcissist, okay? And this is coming from people that said they went to school for psychology. I'm just somebody that knows, because I be around a lot of narcs, all right? And you are definitely one, and I feel so bad for that one woman that you're leeching onto. I know exactly why you're doing it, but I ain't gonna say nothing until I make this video expressing my feelings towards you and your personality disorder. Girl, you on your Kanye right now, bugged out. Let me start about the interview with Star. These are things that you did not do as a journalist. You did not say allegedly, not once. Not even a disclaimer in the beginning of the video. You didn't even have to say allegedly. You could have said, this is not my words. This is coming from her. This is her story, her personal story. I'm going to respect it. Believe it if you want. You didn't say anything. All right, number one, when it came to that interview, you were so biased and you could tell from the beginning. I just want to place certain parts, certain tidbits. I was going to do a video to where you can actually see the interview on the screen, but I know that Tasha is the type of person that will get my video taken down because of it.
Because it was a lot, all right?
Yes.
So, there was a lot that you spilled. You said that Cardi B prostituted.
Yes.
She was a drug user.
Yes.
Cocaine and Molly, to be specific.
Yes.
Okay. She has herpes.
Yes.
All right. Let's talk about the herpes first, because Cardi B did come back and address. She kind of gave a little statement on the relationship between you and her. She said that you two lived in the same building, but that doesn't mean that she knows you. Okay. So let's start from the beginning.
Okay.
What do you have to say about Cardi B denying that she does not know you and that you guys actually lived in the same building?
Wait, Tasha, I'm noticing this now while I'm playing the interview. You just asked her to start off with a certain topic, then you change it to something else. You suck at interviewing, I'm telling you. I mean, your people could say whatever they want. Honestly, I don't care. Because I was Team Tasha for a little while. You know, I was a little annoyed by you and your voice sometimes and your antics and certain behaviors. But I put up with it because I noticed that another blogger looked at you as a friend. So I'm like, oh, maybe you're good people. But I see right through you, Tosh. Right through you. And we're the same age. I think I'm older than you. You need to grow the fuck up. You was telling Cardi to grow the fuck up. You need to grow the fuck up. Where your baby at? Hmm? You don't like when people insult you, right? But it's okay to do it to others. Ooh, when I make that video talking about your narcissism, girl, you are going to hide under a rock. All right. You rushed the interview, right? You rushed it because you wanted to be the first to have it, exclusive. But when you did that, you gave us trash. If you took your time to do the research like other people did, then you wouldn't have looked this fool. You really wouldn't have. And as far as a part two, now I'm hearing that there's going to be a part two. And I think it's because you reading comments of other people saying that there were no receipts, this and this and this and that. But guess what? Miss Mona came out with a live today expressing that there were never any receipts. And she said, if you do come up with receipts, let me see if I still got that video up. She said, if you come up with receipts, they are doctored.
I know how you make podcasts off money off podcast. I don't even think the YouTube would give a fuck if it's a lot of truth. Because from what I heard, they make fake receipts. That's what they do. So, yeah, you got, when a bitch put out a receipt and they tell you a receipt is a picture from months ago and it corroborates a story, only stupid people believe in that. Brains, y'all believe that shit? Now she's sending me a fucking podcast. Girl, what is you doing?
Okay, basically, if you guys want to listen to that, that's Miss Mona Simone on YouTube. She has a few videos explaining the situation with her star and Tasha. In this video, she's actually making a live, but star Marie is watching the live, and she's texting her at the same time. And you know when somebody's guilty of lying, they just keep trying to convince you that they didn't do something wrong. It's so weird, like, for instance, when the girl was telling her story, when she was talking to Tasha, I noticed that sometimes her story would just drastically change into something about health. And then you could see her demeanor change. Like, go back and watch the video. Her demeanor changes when she's talking to Tasha about things that she really does know. But when she's lying, she'll be like this. She'll be looking up. And then when she gets back to something that is probably the truth or a little bit, you know, off, she could look at Tasha in the eyes and continue, and then she goes back and looks up again. Stuff like that I noticed throughout. There was many discrepancies throughout the story. If I could, I would go ahead and play all these parts, but I noticed that the time is, I don't want to make this like a super long video, but let's go to one discrepancy that I did put. I don't know what it is. It was a conversation she had with her manager. Oh, yes, receipts.
To me, he said, you told your friend you have herpes, so you can't work in my club telling people that you have herpes. Unless, I said, well, if I go get you a test, because my herpes is not active. That's what I told him. I kept it like I was very educational with him. I said,
oh, I see what you were saying. So she basically manipulated what you told her about everybody having herpes. That's
exactly. Okay. Exactly. And so I was like, well, my herpes is not active.
You notice how Tasha is feeding her and she'll agree? Anytime Tasha feeds her, like, oh, so what you're saying is she manipulated you. She manipulated everybody to think that you had herpes. Is that what you're saying? And then start, yes ma'am, yes ma'am. Bitch, why the fuck are you calling her ma'am?
And he was like, what do you mean by that?
So it was probably like, wait a minute, huh? Right. So you do have it.
Okay. Right, and a lot of times, you know, I gotta be careful because I come off like a weirdo to people who are not as educated as me. But
that's another thing that liars do. I notice what they do when they start to feel a little nervous that they're going to get caught in a lie, and then you get to a part in a conversation where you start to laugh, they get a little bit of relief because they probably feel like they got to you a little. Watch the video, you'll see. You'll see. She'll laugh and talk about little irrelevant things.
I said, I never wanted to strip in the beginning. I was 34 stripping. Okay. I mean, I was... Well, you look good. I had to, because I needed the money, you know? So, I was already educated before I went out there trying to get extra money to pay off what I needed to pay off.
Okay, this wasn't really important, but I'm going to get to a part where she mention her boss. It stuck out to me, but we'll see.
Jaw back in 2 weeks, but this was two between that time and the guy that we went to the hotel with and the punching in the face and the
okay
and all that. That was all brewing for 2 weeks. I didn't even know about this. So between the herpes thing and her taking me out with the guy and her being mad at me.
Most of the time going to the grocery store with the kids is fun. What makes it challenging is if I have to go to more than.
That all happened in that week, but I had got suspended for 2 weeks. So I was out of the loop for 2 weeks.
Listen to her clearly. Like it gave me a migraine. Earlier, when I was trying to understand her story, it's really mumble jumble. I'm gonna play that one more time.
In order to save your job, you went and got tested, brought him back the test results.
Yes.
And he basically, you kept your job.
Well, I got my job back in 2 weeks, but this was two between that time and the guy that we went to the hotel with and the punching in the face and the
okay
and all that. That was all brewing for 2 weeks. I didn't even know about this. So between the herpes thing and her taking me out with the guy and her being mad at me, that all happened in that week. But I had got suspended for 2 weeks. So I was out of the loop for 2 weeks.
Oh, so this was after the altercation.
This was before. Okay. When.
This is where it doesn't make sense to me. She's telling a story, but she'll say before and then eventually when she tells a story like deeper, she's telling Tasha it happened after. So that would mean that you got suspended from your job twice for 2 weeks. I don't know. Just makes no sense. Maybe it's the way you're putting it. It just doesn't sound right. It was brewing.
Extra money to pay off what I need to pay off and get the hell out of there.
Okay. So in order to save your job, you went and got tested, brought him back the test results.
Yes.
And he basically, you kept your job.
Well, I got my job back in 2 weeks, but this was two between that time and the guy that we went to the hotel with and the punching in the face and the
okay
and all that. That was all brewing all for 2 weeks. I didn't even know about this. So between the herpes thing and her taking me out with the guy and her being mad at me. That all happened in that week, but I had got suspended for 2 weeks, so I was out of the loop for 2 weeks.
Oh, so this was after the altercation.
This was before. Okay, when I spoke to her about the herpes.
You hear that?
The next day, the guy came and he threw $1,000 on us, and then we went to the hotel. And
hey, you guys, did you hear her say he threw $1,000 on us? Her first live, she said. Cardi was jealous because he threw $1,000 on me. That's what she said. I know that's really minor, but
and he said that her coochie stank and all that stuff. And then I got to work the next day. My boss told me I couldn't work. And I was like, why? When I got to the front door.
Wait a minute. Okay, so in your live, I just have to get it
straight. Because it's a lie.
Okay, uh-huh. In your live, you said that she asked you to go out to eat with her. So you guys actually went to a hotel?
We went out to eat.
Okay.
And I didn't want to go because it was like I worked a triple shift. That happened on a Thursday because I was getting. That happened on a Wednesday because I wanted to fly out on Friday. Yeah. So I worked from 12 in the afternoon. No, when the club opens, yeah, like I got there at like 3 in the afternoon, I believe. And I worked from 3 in the afternoon.
These are mannerisms.
I forgot the time frame, but I worked day shift, mid shift, and night shift. I did a triple.
Okay.
That day I was tired as hell. And I told her, I said, you know, I do not go do extras because I'm out on probation. I don't want to get arrested for selling coochie. I mean, honestly, I was out on bail. Look, when I first went to New York, I was out on bail.
Okay.
I was out on bail here. And I was
She repeats that she's out on bail. She was on probation. She couldn't leave. She couldn't do anything. And Tasha, not once. You didn't ask her why. Do you mind if I ask, like, what were your legal problems about? Say something. Because, yeah, we want to hear what happened with Cardi and stuff like that, but can we understand, like, this chick and her issues as well so we could, you know what I'm saying, have some sort of equal, I don't know, whatever. I'm not as articulate as Star, like you would say, Tasha. My bad. And that was the dumbest thing that I've ever heard. Oh, I believe her, all right. Her story is true. And I don't care. Nobody, no receipts can change my mind. She did not stutter throughout that entire interview. I believe her. Tasha, you are dumb. Ugh. All right. So, you said the man threw $1,000 at you after you educated Cardi about the herps. Then you went to the hotel, and then you mentioned the whole thing about Cardi smelling, right? This woman says she was the only one that showered that night. She woke up to a man giving her head. I don't know what person does not feel when somebody is... Whatever. Everybody's different. I'm not going to say anything. But your contradictions just... You went from talking about the man saying that Cardi smelled, but this is after he ate you out. Because when you guys were having a conversation, you kept jumping from one thing to the next, one thing to the next. And I could not understand the story clearly. It just was, it gave me a headache. And this is my third time trying to break the interview down. But I could barely take any types of notes because it was just so all over the place. I noticed that liars do some things. Like, for instance, she said to Tasha, we could go, I'll go to the hotel, that five-star hotel, and ask them for the tapes. We're in 2018, about to be 2019. This happened back in 2013. Girl, you know damn well, ain't no five-star hotel, don't matter who the fuck it is, White House, nobody's gonna have that shit. It's over, like, 2013, and really, they're gonna look back for... Star Marie did that because she knows that there's no possible way. Just like Star when she came out on that video and she said, I'm willing to go on Queen's Radio and do a lie detector test. Because you know damn well ain't nobody gonna go to Queen's Radio with you to go do no damn lie detector test. And you probably feel like you could manipulate it with your lies that you believe because you're a pathological liar. That's what you guys really think you could beat anything. And they're inadmissible at court. So who gives a fuck if you take one? I feel like some of your story is true. But not you living with Cardi or having any type of relationship. I know for a fact that Spotlight punched you in the face. And I have receipts on that. When Tasha, you come out with your receipts to try to prove that Spotlight incriminated herself. Guess what? I have some receipts as well. I'm waiting for you to come out with your video. Your fuckery. You're not going to play Spotlight. I don't know Cardi, but I know Spotlight. You're not going to fuck with her. Alrighty. Like I said, there was plenty indiscrepancies. If you guys listened to the interview, you would know. There's probably some that people will show you online. Because I've been seeing a couple of videos like pointing them out. And it's hilarious. When Star mentioned that Cardi was trying to fight her, and you know, Cardi was how she usually is, like ghetto and doing, like, you know, trying to fight and stuff. But then when she described Cardi earlier, she said Cardi was a nice girl. She was just a regular Spanish girl, quiet or whatever. And now it was, she's nothing like she is right now. But then you describe the Cardi right now as the Cardi that you were living with. Make it story, like, make me understand. How does the story change so often? Oh boy, I took so many notes, guys, for the things that were like I wanted to point out. Hold on. Oh, Tasha, let me play some of the shade that you threw. It was so whack of you. So whack of you.
No, I'm not in the business of selling vagina. I'm not doing it. I don't want to get involved in this. I'm not doing it.
Well, she did have a song called Fuck 'em, then get some money. So, I mean.
Right. So, the reason why I didn't want to sell coochie.
She ain't even pay you no mind with that whack ass joke. You was talking about she don't write her own rhymes. So, bitch, what the fuck are you talking about? What are you talking about? You don't like the girl. Just, it's obvious. Okay? You don't like her. Ugh. Can't stand people like you that try to make it seem like you're unbiased, but you're so biased as fuck. You blocked that I Am Hater Marie page, and I saw how rude you were when that person was trying to give you receipts, and then you just went off on them, then you blocked them. Like, you're so dumb. You didn't want to see anybody's evidence to prove that Cardi had nothing to do with this girl or Spotlight and whatever. I offered Spotlight. I kept saying this and this and that. If you want to talk to my friend, ignore. But you'll comment to all the other fuckery on your page. Anybody that was praising you, you would acknowledge them. And ignore anybody that had real tea questions to ask you. Real good points. I noticed that, Tasha. You really did that. All right. There was a lot of deflecting in here, too. Like, ugh. She would start talking about something and then change the damn topic. Let's go to the Offset and herpes thing, which, again, bothered me.
You want your life.
Yeah.
Because I know what you're about. You're disgusting.
Now, let me ask you something. Do you think, and I should have asked you this earlier in the interview, do you think, because you came for Offset too, and you said Offset had a herpes blister too. Now, do you think somehow, because you said she had this before Fame, that she somehow gave it to Offset?
Well, I wouldn't say that, but this is what I said. I said, Offset, don't think you gave that to her.
Oh, okay. Like, I missed that part.
Because a lot of times you get these women that play victim.
Okay.
And they won't tell the guy what's wrong with them. I know because I'm a natural healer.
And you know what? I said this during my live last night.
I know because I'm a natural healer. No, she's not. Let me tell you something. She was fucking Dr. Sebi. She was. Number two, there's this guy. What's his name? Yada. I wish Yada would come out and tell his story. Yada exposed her. And she was staying in a village where, you know, they eat dirt and stuff like that and drink sea moss and stuff, right? She was trying to seduce the man. There are receipts of people expressing that. And I know somebody that was part of this whole Yada thing, and they were talking to me about Star Marie. Yes. And I never knew it was Star Marie until I started seeing receipts now. So crazy how the world is. Like, I didn't know Spotlight knew Cardi B. I knew Spotlight, right? I just thought she was a Cardi B fan, right? When I saw the video of Star and I heard Spotlight's name, I immediately hit her up. Because I was like, there's only one Spotlight that I know, and it's got to be her. Because Spotlight, she's no joke. She's real petite, cute. But she ain't no joke. Yeah, I completely forgot what I was about to say. But listen. Yes, the Offset thing. Listen real quick.
Selena Powell and 50 Cent. If 50 got herpes and Selena has herpes and she confirms that he doesn't have herpes because he don't know if he got herpes from her, if she got herpes, it's just a mess.
This is what I said because I'm a healer and I work with females a lot. I work with a lot of females. And the reason why my business is not all high and all that stuff is because, of course, I'm working with people that have.
Now, do you see what I'm talking about? They'll go from talking about something and then change the topic completely. Now she's talking about something she's comfortable with. So therefore, she, like, her demeanor changes. Like, if you pay attention to when she's being asked a question about Cardi B to her talking about something that indeed did happen. I heard that she said she's been to like 40 something countries. How the fuck? I need to find that on this interview, because how the fuck did you go to that many countries with no job? No job. What are you doing? Are you tricking? Please tell me. Are you tricking? Because there's no way that you could afford to do that when there's people out here that have 2-3 jobs and they can't even take a damn trip to Disney World. You know what I'm saying? They gotta save up for years. And you've been to 40-something countries. Bitch, where's your passport? I would have been like, where the fuck is your passport? Makes no damn sense for somebody to be lying like that and never provide any receipts. Like I said, Tasha, you feed the answers. I had some examples of you feeding answers, but I'm not even going to play them because I don't think these are good ones. I'm going to see if we're going to take this for a try. Like I said, I took notes on certain things, but I just rather this video not be my detailed one because I can't show Tasha's video.
Fuck her.
Oh.
And then she took it out on me. So of course she jumped fly with me and
so she just left. Did she leave?
She didn't leave. No, okay. she went wild like she usually do, but he was holding her the whole time. And then I was like, little girl, she was 20, I'm 34 at the time. I was like, little girl, I'm not afraid of you. You need to shut up. Like, I'm not afraid of you. You need to calm that down. Stand down. Like, stand down. This ain't got nothing to do with me. We'll talk about this when we get to the house. But she going off in front of this stranger.
Because she's embarrassed.
Right. And I'm telling her, like, look, stand down. Like, when we get to the house, no, you ain't coming back to my house. You getting out today. I was like, okay, no problem. So the guy's like, look, you, I'm going to drive you and her, and I'll go get your bag.
That was not the part, but still, it was fuckery. For your entertainment, for anyone that's into this topic, I know I'm going to get a lot of hate from me just talking about Tasha, but I'm here for it. All right, but anyways, my whole question to Star would be, how dumb do you think we are? Clearly, you do think that nobody's going to notice the inconsistencies in your story. You said that Cardi tried to fight you and she was upset that white guy was holding her back because he said that her pussy stank. Why would another woman be mad at another woman because her pussy stank? And again, Mona has some evidence that you told her a different story, because you did an interview with Mona prior to the one with Tasha, and Mona said you did not have any receipts whatsoever. And if they do come with receipts for Fuckery Friday, them things ain't valid, because you told Mona you had nothing. Oh, and I have one receipt on you, Star. Oh, I'm saving this one. I followed Star momentarily before I got blocked, right? Because I couldn't help my mouth. I had to say something. She posted something and she tagged Cardi B on it. It did not stay up for long. When I went through that post, I read it. It was long. I was reading it. And as I was reading it, this bitch said she fucked up Spotlight. She said, that's why I fucked your girl up. After you sent your girl to come fuck me up, I fucked her up. But then when you do the interview with Tasha, you don't mention anything about fighting anybody or fucking anybody up. When you did your live, you didn't mention anything about fucking anybody up. You made yourself out to be the victim. And it's funny because I'm looking over here like I'm talking to this bitch, because I'm looking at the actual screen that has her face on it. Listen, she legit said that she fucked up Spotlight, but she deleted it. That day, I was responding back, right? And when I hit enter, it says, this post has been deleted. So I was like, damn, y'all. The post is deleted, but it was still on my screen. So I screenshot it. I figured somebody would be able to use it. Because we don't play around here. Tasha keeps talking about that fake book is fake. It's a lie. Tasha, you know damn well that Facebook is real. She deleted everything on there that was of any value to expose her. She did. And you know it, Tasha. And you talk about how she speaks so eloquent. She went to college and all this shit. What the fuck does a college education have to do with anything? Let me tell you something. There's so many people that went to college and they can barely, like, do anything or even find a damn job. And you over here talking about, oh, you believe her because she sounds good. That's what liars do. They sound fucking good. They sound believable. And guess what, Tasha? You're in that same level. You are a liar as well. You tell fake news, you're considered a damn liar. Media takeout. Everybody's saying you're media takeout. I'm seeing all the comments, okay? So it's not just me. You got a lot of people disappointed in you, Tasha, because you put your feelings into this. You posted at least 24 stories about Cardi B within the last 4 days, but about 20 within the last 24 hours. That's kind of creepy, if you ask me. All right. The story is just all over the place. It just don't make no damn sense. There was a part where she was telling the story and Tasha, you cut her off and I never got to hear the rest.
Just leave. Don't come back. Leave. Because I knew that they was talking about calling the cops and all that when I was fighting her friend inside. So he's like, yo, get out of here. Leave. They're going to have you hemmed up. Like, you can't get arrested. Okay. She done threw coffee on you. This one fighting you. They talking about calling the cops. You better go home. So I left the place that I had for rent for the week.
Okay. She mentioned she was fighting here. I didn't hear that before. But the other video, she basically said that she couldn't fight because security or something wouldn't allow her. And now she says she was fighting. She doesn't mention whooping Spotlight's ass like she did on
the police didn't say anything when she threw that hard coffee. Okay.
The police, no.
This is one question.
They tried to kill my
reputation in the club.
So when I came back 2 weeks later, she tried to right there when I came back 2 weeks later, but that didn't work. That wasn't enough. So now you send your friend to punch me in my face. And then when I walk outside, you pour hot coffee on me in front of all these. You know, when you come outside the club, there's a lot of line of police and taxis. She threw hot coffee on me.
And the police didn't say anything when she threw that hot coffee?
The police, no, they didn't. They just regular out police officers that's out there. They see girls arguing and everything. DJ Days on before the cop could turn around and...
You see how fast she switched the topic, kind of? Listen one more time. It's the little things that I notice about when people are lying, you know? I suck at lying. I really do. You could read it all on my face. So I could tell when somebody's lying.
They tried to kill my
reputation in the club.
So when I came back 2 weeks later, she tried to right there when I came back 2 weeks later, but that didn't work. That wasn't enough. So now you send your friend to punch me in my face. And then when I walk outside, you pour hot coffee on me in front of all these. You know, when you come outside the club, there's a lot of line of police and taxis. She threw hot coffee on me.
And the police didn't say anything when she threw that hot coffee?
The police, no, they didn't. They just regular out police officers that's out there. They see girls arguing and everything. DJ Days on before the cop could turn around and say something, he stuffed me in the cab because the cab car was like right here.
Because you was about to pop off.
And DJ Days on, which was a friend of mine, he knew, they all knew that I was on probation. Okay. Everybody who worked in the club, because like I said, I was a money maker there. Everybody liked me. You know, I had rapport there. It was like a family. So he stuffed me in the cab and he was like, get out of here now, go.
You guys, I have to show you this video. I know this is a long ass. I know that this is long, but this video is gonna make you laugh, okay? She says that she was one of the top money makers there. She was great. She was whatever. Spotlight told me that she was mad weird. She was a weirdo and nobody liked her, right? And she said, and she couldn't dance. She danced really awkward, right? So all of a sudden, I'm seeing that she does this interview with Tasha talking about she was making like $1,000 to $2,000 a night, Monday through Friday. She made between $4,000 to $8,000. That is bullshit. Because I've seen some really bad ass strippers that never made that much every single night. There's no way. And I've been to Sue's, boo. You ain't make that much. Y'all. I hope you can see. The one in the far back, right there, the fast one. That's the fast one. Yo, it's hilarious. I hope you can see it. Yo. Now that's who made $2,000 a night dancing like that. She mentioned that she worked in three clubs, but I don't think she mentioned Lust. Lust, I think it's called. I want to see that before I end this video.
The club that maybe could get her a better job at Sue's.
Okay.
So
and what,
she ran
what
up
year
on me.
Was this?
This was in 2013.
Okay. Okay. So she was Caramella before she adopted the name Bacardi, and then it became Cardi B.
Okay. Exactly.
Okay.
Well, she was Caramella, then Ratchet, then Bacardi.
She was Ratchet.
Yeah, they called her Ratchet too.
I think that would have fit her more. So. Hey, she's shade. The brand. That's what it is. Hey. Okay.
So and, shady. She ran up on me on the street. I came out of work that night. It had to be like, I don't know, like 4 in the morning. I was getting, you know, more better in that club. So I ended up just kind of making it my home club. And I dropped the other two. But I met
Wait.
Was getting outside in front of another strip club that I was working at.
Okay.
Because I was working at 3 different strip clubs in New York when I first got there. But then Sue's, I started getting more clients and the girls started liking me and I was getting, you know, more better in that club. So I ended up just kind of making it my home club and I dropped the other two. But I met her on 40th Street.
Okay.
Damn, this sucks because I don't know if she mentioned the names. I think she made a mistake in this video. There are a couple of videos that I've seen floating around where she made mistakes in Tasha's interview. Unfortunately, I did not make this video like most YouTubers do. I'm very unprofessional at this point. I don't care for edits. This is just girl talk, guy talk, whoever wants to listen to me express my views on Tasha and her fake news. Yeah, there was a couple of things that I wrote down and I can't find it. Oh well, whatever, it doesn't matter. You guys, I can't wait until tomorrow's receipts come out. Once they do, I'm definitely going to do a update on how I feel. If you care, I don't mind if you don't. YouTube is here for whoever just wants to like watch whatever it is what they want to watch. I get bored sometimes with people too, but there are some people that actually enjoy listening to me talk. I get people that complain that I talk too slow and too low. There's people that enjoy when I play music in the background, which I usually do. Not for this video, because I just wanted to read Tasha a little bit. And y'all needed to hear my voice. Guys, right now I think I'm just going to be sipping tea. I'll sip my wine at home. But I'm just going to be sipping tea and watching Lovely. Because she's very unbiased. Regardless, sometimes I don't think she likes Cardi. Or even Nicki much. She just reports the damn news. That's why I love that girl so much. I've been watching her since before she was even really talking about celebs. She would talk about regular shit too. Like let's say a news story. That's what I call regular shit. Not celebs. Now her video exposing Star Marie was amazing. And in my head, I'm like, how is this gonna work? Because Tasha and her are friends. I know that they talk to each other and share tips. So why didn't this tip get to her? And does she care? And then I started thinking, maybe this is a prank. Then I'm like, nah, it can't be a prank. Nah, it's not a prank. What if Tasha really does have receipts? And then I thought back to the things that I really know about Star. And one of her friends has been telling me some things. And they are corroborated by me looking at Star Marie's Twitter. Yeah, she has a Twitter. She has not logged on for years. So a lot of those receipts are invalid because she didn't know Cardi back then too. So, but as far as something that happened with her husband, I know that because her friend told me. And guys, I'm not even going to go there because anything could happen to anyone. Any one of us. Don't judge people. But I just think she was wrong for talking about herpes and stuff like that as if it was a STD down here when we're talking about, you know, a cold sore. Little kids have cold sores too. And another thing, the Monistat thing. They do not sell Monistat in bulk, bitch. They don't. One pack of that is like $18. Okay? $20. And you said she had like a pack of 100. Where the fuck she get that from? Those don't exist. I used to work at Costco. Okay? They don't exist. And they would never sell them like that unless you were your doctor's office. You're just trying to play the girl. And then for Tasha to go ahead and make the freaking title be Cardi B had boxes of Monistat. Bitch, you're so foul for that. Your mouth is full of yeast. You need to fucking choke on a damn Monistat stick, bitch. That was real fucked up of you. I honestly don't give a fuck if you block me either. But let me see. I can't believe you changed the title. Like, you legit started this shit and you put roommate, then dance mate. Now you put roommate again. Fake fuck. Allegedly kept boxes of Monistat 7 and reveals more. What was the point of this entire interview? Why? If this happened back in 2013, we're in 2018, about to be 19. Why the fuck is this even relevant? And Tasha, did you know that those two women that apparently said that they were attacked, that story didn't fit? It was false? And you interviewed Star Marie because she wanted to get some attention off of it. Notice how Star Marie didn't say anything? Talking about, oh, she did it because of the strippers, right? You noticed how Star Marie did not say one word until the Nicki Minaj shit went down. That's when she wanted to come out. This shit was strategically done. Regardless if she knew how to save her life, she knew that the rumor would get out. Once you get it out, and you're talking about a celebrity like Cardi B, you know that the shit is gonna spread like wildfire. That's why Tasha has all these new barbs following her, because of that. Okay? But anyways, like I said, this interview was trash. Anybody that says that it was great, it was very informative, I'm not going to try to be disrespectful here, but it shows what type of person you are if you think that that was a wonderful interview. It just wasn't. I wanted it to be, and I promise you, like, I really did want to like Tasha so much. But the bad vibes that I was getting lately, especially after she recently asked everybody to go attack that poor freaking black queen that had no clue about your damn podcast. You just assume everybody knows about your podcast, or excuse me, your blog. Not everybody cares about celebrity drama, Tasha. So stop assuming just because somebody thinks of something like Unwind With Me that they're copying you. Because there's plenty of people that drink wine every day, me included. There's plenty of people that say, wine down, let's do wine down Wednesdays. Stop. Just get over yourself, Tosh. Get over yourself. I can't believe I made a video this long talking about it. But, you know, it's just my thoughts and opinion. I could have been more detailed to tell you more things that I felt were inconsistent. But again, I just couldn't stomach listening to the interview again, like straight through. I just couldn't do it. So I just gave you a couple of pieces of things that were on my mind. And stay tuned, because you guys, I believe that Tasha's receipts are going to be invalid. I can promise you that. Peace.